You're welcome, my brothers and sisters, and I want to thank God for your life. This is the beginning of a new year, and I know God who has brought you has something peculiar in store for you. You will not miss it in the name of Jesus. The Bible says very clearly in Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 15, the labor of the foolish wearies every one of them because they don't know the way to the city. There's a way to the city. There's a city in every profession. There's a city in every trade. There's a city in every life. There's a city. You know, you will see the physical city, but there's a city that is bigger than the physical city. And if you are a trader and you have not entered into the city of your trade, you will be in the village of your trade. That's why that scripture says, the labor of the foolish wearieth every one of them, because they don't know the way to the city. And that's why one of the great things God will do for you this year is to lead you to the city. You have stayed too long in the village. Even though you are in Lagos, you are still in the village. Physically, you are in Lagos, but you are in the village. Jesus spoke about that cult that was tied. The cult was supposed to be in the city, but it was tied somewhere in the village. Until Jesus sent for the cult. And when they brought the cult to the city, come and see celebration. There are so many people who are in the village of their trade. Many are in the village of their ministry. Many are in the village of what God has called them to do. But by the unction of the Holy Spirit, you will relocate to the city this year. In the name of Jesus. I'm sure you understand what I'm saying. I met one man some time ago in America. He said, the first few years I spent here, he said, life was more horrible for me than when I was even in the place I live as a slum in Lagos. He said, it was the place I saw the first biggest rat. He said, the rat I saw is bigger than the one I saw in the slum where I stayed in Lagos. In every place, there's a village. There's a slum everywhere. The first time I went, I think it was Canada, and I saw beggars on the street. I said, even here? Even here? Even in this place, they still get beggars on the street. I pray for you this year, the Lord will lead you to the city. And that's where I'm starting this message from. We're going to pray three prayers. That was the prayer we used to close the service, the blood service. We're going to use it to start this one. That this year, you will not make mistake. This year, the Lord will lead you. In the name of Jesus. I want you to rise up on your feet. Just three quick prayers before I bring the word. In Psalm 78, verse 53, he said, he led them safely so that they feared not, but the sea overwhelmed their enemies. He led them safely. And because he was the one leading them safely, they had no fear. You are going to open your mouth and say, oh Lord, this year, you will lead me to a place of safety. You will lead my family to a place of safety. We shall not fear this year. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Father, lead us safely. Lead us safely. In my department, you will lead us safely. In our church, lead us safely. That we will have no fear. And let the sea overwhelm every opposition as you lead us. In the name of Jesus, let every opposition be overwhelmed by the sea. In the name of Jesus, as you lead us, in the name of Jesus, as you lead us to a place of safety, as you lead us safely, every destruction on the way, they shall be overwhelmed by the sea. In the name of Jesus, let the sea overwhelm every destruction on the way, as you lead us safely, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for hearing. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Ah, I didn't like that, your amen. I said the Lord will lead you safely this year in the name of Jesus. This year, there shall be no destruction in your home in the name of Jesus. Number two, he led them in the right way. Thank God for the RP on Tuesday. He told us that there's a right way, there's a wrong way. Even when the Bible says there is a way that seemeth right, it means there must be a wrong one. Are you following me today? Some people took the wrong way. And this is the beginning of the year. If somebody takes wrong way now, it's too early. I was saying it, was it during the breakfast with the king last Thursday? I said, if you are going to Ibadan, and you head for Badagry, where is he sleeps, and you begin to go, and the people are calling you on phone, say, where are you now? You say, in fact, I just passed Lasso now, and I'm speeding. In fact, I'm on 140 already. Does that make you to reach Ibadan? Some people, it's too early in the year, and they will take the wrong way. A young man took a wrong way. He was in his final year, almost finishing. He has written project, everything. He was just waiting, you know, playing around in the school. Then some gang came to him, and they told him that, oh boy, you can make money. Oh. He said, how? He said, please, just come and join us. We'll write exam for people. 100 level, 200 level, 300 level. Depending on your level, we can write mass-related exam for you because they are engineering students, a team. You see, he went and joined them. The day they were going to catch them, only himself they catch. They didn't catch the other people. You know, those who have been doing it for long, himself, now the trial. They catch him. And when they caught him, it took him 7 years to get his certificate. He has finished everything just to collect certificate. The Senate said no, they should not give him. Every year he will write. Every year he will send great big men to go and beg them. The seventh year, the year of release, was the year that they gave him the certificate. By the fourth year, he went and enrolled for another degree. The year he was finishing that one was the year they gave him the second certificate. I pray for you and I pray for your children. This year, they will not join the wrong gang. They won't join the wrong company. In the name of Jesus, look at what he says. Psalm 107:7. And he led them forth by the right way, that they might go to a city of habitation. That's what that scripture says. He says, because they don't know the way to the city. They don't know the right way to the city. You are going to open your mouth and say, oh Lord, this year you will lead me in the right way. I will not take the wrong way. I will not join the wrong company. Lead me the right way. Open your mouth and pray. Pray for yourself. Say, Father, this year you will lead me in the right way. In the name of Jesus. You will lead me in the right way. In the name of Jesus, you will lead my children the right way. In the name of Jesus, as a family, you will lead us the right way. Lead us the right way. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Oh, your amen is not very strong. And that prayer is very important too. One man collected all his final entitlement. I think I've told you before. I mean, it was his housing. He collected housing loan. He went and cashed it. And he was keeping it in his office. They said there is fire drill. And his office was on the 10th floor. You know the first thing he carried? Now the bag where contained the money. He carried it. Anywhere they said they should go and gather. He would gather there at the mustering point. And while he was there, some people came. They said, oh boy, 30% per month. He said, that would be a good idea. So that if I fix it for 2 years, the third year now, I'll go and build. As he part with the money, he see I'm going, you know, see I'm come back. This year, you will not take a wrong decision. Finally, you are going to pray. There's a way of abundance. He said in Psalm 66:12b, he said, we went through fire and flood, but you brought us to a place of abundance. This year, the Lord will bring you to a place of abundance. I don't know what you went through last year, but this is a brand new year. Let me inform your neighbor, say, this is a brand new year. Very brand new, very brand new. God said, forget about the past, just new one I'm going to do now, brand new. One translation says, God wants to do brand new things. Not Tokumbo. Brand new this year. In the name of the Lord Jesus. You are going to open your mouth and say, oh Lord, lead me to the place of abundance. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Father, lead us to the place of abundance. Lead us to the place of abundance. In the name of Jesus. There's a place of abundance. You went through fire and flood last year, but you are taking us to a place of abundance. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. For in Jesus' name we have prayer. Father, we thank you for this morning. We give you praise for your word. Forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. Thank you for the authority of your word. Father, this morning we ask you to send your word. Bible says you sent your word and it healed them and delivered them from all their destructions. Today, let your word save. Today, let your word heal. Today, let your word deliver. In the name of Jesus. At the end, your name will be glorified. Thank you, Father, because you have heard. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Very quickly, I'm be speaking this morning on creating your great abundance. You can create your own great abundance. It's in your hands. You can create it by yourself. And you know, that just reminds me. You know, each time God sent his word, I was listening to somebody. He said, you need to pay attention to details. To God, details are very important. Do you know the reason why Moses missed the promised land? It was lack of details. God told him, speak to the rock. He went and beat the rock. It's lack of details. And God is interested in details. You know, when Elisha was about to die, in the book of 2 Kings, if you read it, 2 Kings chapter 13, when he was about to die, there was a king who so believed in his ministry that the king began to cry. He said, my father, my father, my father, my father, my father is dying. My father is dying. Ah, and all these battles surrounding me. How am I going to win it without my father? And Elisha said, don't cry. If it's this last one, you will win. You will win it. And Elisha instructed him. He said, my friend, go to the window and shoot arrow. The first mistake he made, he should have asked question how many times. He didn't ask. The second mistake he made, he went and shot. How many times did he shoot? 3 times. And he stopped. When he came back, the man of God said, who asked you to stop? Because you have stopped, you will only defeat them 3 times. The 4th time, if you try, they will defeat you. Why? No attention to details. I have said it again and again that great abundance is not fruitfulness. Fruitfulness is just one. Because if you look at your Bible, the only thing you can equate to great abundance is blessings. In Genesis 1:22, it says, and the Lord blessed them. And the Lord said, be fruitful. That's just one. And multiply and replenish the earth, subdue it and have dominion. You see, there is more than just fruitfulness. But some people, you know, they have this mental picture that anytime you talk anything abundance, it's fruitfulness. It's lack of paying attention to details. And what it does is shortchanges people. Because after of almost 9, or even, you know, some people told me, they said, Daddy, you told us 9, but I have discovered more in the Bible. The more you discover, that's why you are the one to create your own great abundance. Where he said, be it unto you according to your faith. Do you know that this great abundance for some people now only healing? No. To some, it's only healing. Because that's where the shoe is pinching them. To some people, this great abundance is only for peace. Oh, because they've not enjoyed peace. Peace in their home. So there's a great abundance of peace. That's the only thing they had. Some people now, great abundance of a fruit. That's the only thing they had. But that's not it. It's great abundance in every realm as you create it by yourself. That's why I'm preaching this morning. Creating your own great abundance. And my prayer is that the Lord will help you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You see, the easiest way to create your abundance is to speak it into existence. Words are the raw material in the spiritual realm. I just heard that scientists have discovered that words that were spoken many, many years ago can actually be recalled. They were not recorded then, but they said those words are still in the atmosphere waiting to manifest. There are people who are fighting battles, spiritual battles, that were created as a result of words that were spoken. That's why sometimes in deliverance, we talk about nullifying words that were spoken into people's lives. And if it is true negatively, then it is true positively. There's a man of God that operated by words. And that's the one I'm going to use to preach this morning. And that was Elijah. Anything Elijah wants, he will say it. And when he says it, he will pursue it. And at the end of the day, Elijah must see it. I pray for you this morning. Whatever you say, you will see. Ah, be careful before you say amen. Oh. It's a very powerful prayer. In Genesis chapter 1, from verse 3, the Bible says, and God said, let there be light. And before it ended, he said, and God saw the light. Beloved, in creating your own great abundance, what you say is what you see. What you say is what you see. Particularly if you say it in line with God's word. That's why I love that hymn. Standing on the promises of God. When you stand on God's word, you can literally create your own world. Somebody is complaining. I don't even know how this world be. You are creating it with your mouth. Year 2020 to some people is the best year in the universe. In fact, they were praying that it shouldn't end. Whereas when your job were praying that it should quickly go away. I pray for you today. May 2021 be your best year. That's why I'm bringing a word like this. Creating your own great abundance, your own. Customize it. You know, people say they customize car. They customize. Don't let it be the general one. You customize it. When you customize it, we mentioned 9. Your own can even be 100. That is customization. Creating your own great abundance. Elijah was very good in that. Words are spiritual substances. They are real. They are tangible and they are forceful. In Job chapter 6, verse 25, the Bible says, how forcible are right words. Words carry force. Particularly when it's the word of God. He said the word of God is quick and powerful. Sharper than any two-edged sword. Anytime I get a rhema of the word, I'm excited. Nothing can stand on my way. The moment I have a word from the Lord, and I'm confident on that word, if you like, just stay on the road. You are crushed. You can't stand on his way. He said he's sharper than any two-edged sword. Pierce it through. The asunder, he passed through. He break barriers. The first man to invent printing. Something Gutenberg is a German. He invented printing. And when he invented printing, there were so many court cases against him. You know, contending the propriety of the fact that he's the first person to invent printing. And this man was involved in these court cases, so many of them. Until one day, the Lord just opened his eyes. He started printing Bible. The moment he started printing Bible, all the cases started dropping one by one, one by one, one by one, one by one. And he said he just got an understanding that the Bible says, so mightily grew the word of God and prevailed. Anybody inside who the word of God grows cannot suffer defeat. Because the word of God has the capacity and the ability to fight any battle. He said, so mightily grew the word. That's why again and again, when God calls any man, the first thing he accuses him with is the word. Say, Joshua, Moses, my servant, is there. Thou therefore arise. I said, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt have good success. He recommended the word to him from day one of his operation. So mightily grew the word of God and prevailed. Throughout the Bible, men of God keep speaking, and it came to pass. As they spoke, they experienced it. In Proverbs 18, verse 20, the Bible says, a man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth and with the increase of his lips. In other words, the greater your mouth, the greater your abundance. Is somebody with me today? He said, a man's mouth is what will satisfy him. If your mouth is small, a man of God once said, he said, what you are not bold to declare, you are not worthy to possess. And Umar Pai said, a closed mouth is a closed destiny. No wonder. The Bible says, open your mouth wide and I'll fill it. God is waiting to operate with words. From the beginning, he himself started the game. And God said, when God saw what he didn't like, he was not complaining. What he did was to use his word to shape the world into what he wanted. I want to appeal to somebody today. When you see anything you don't like, don't grumble, don't complain. Go to the place of prayer and use your word to change it. Some women are very good at it. You know a man, when a man say, this television must be here, and you a woman, you say, no, daddy, that's not the best place. Let you come down because it can fall here. You say, no, no, mommy, you must be here. And then you say, to avoid argument, leave it there. And then you go and pray. By himself, he will one day come and carry it. He will not tell you, so that you will not make fun of him. He will carry it and put it here. And if you love yourself, don't refer to it. Because if you refer to it, he will carry it again and put it back. Women who are wise, they shape their homes in the place of prayer with their words. These words that you see, the Bible says the things that were seen were framed by the word of God. His words. When God started creation, there was nothing. The Bible says, and the earth was form, was void and without form. Then God began to shape it with his words. Just like we have started a brand new year. Do you know that by the end of this year, some people will have testimonies in every area of great abundance? Because of the expectation and the way they have shaped the year with their words. Why people are complaining? That's why Job 22:29, he said, when men are cast down, thou shalt say, there is a lifting up. He said, and he shall save the humble person. God is waiting for what you will say. I preached a message some time ago. What are you saying? Heaven is waiting for what you will say. He went to Jeremiah and he showed him. He said, what do you say? He went to Ezekiel and he asked him, what do you say? Ezekiel said, God, you know, I don't want to run myself into trouble. Oh, this one I don't understand. Oh, but you know everything. And he said, okay, since you don't have an opinion, now say this. Prophesy to these dry bones. And Ezekiel began to say after him. And as Ezekiel was saying it, he was seeing it come to pass. He was seeing it. I'm sure Ezekiel himself was shocked. A pastor told me, he said he has never seen it before, that he went somewhere to do navigation. As he was ministering, as he raised his hand, he said people began to fall. He said himself, he has forgotten. He now put his hand behind. He was watching. Because that was his first time experience. I'm sure Ezekiel must have been shocked. But he started on a clean note. God, you know. And then God began to tell him, he said, prophesy. Prophesy. That's what God is telling us. Prophesy great abundance to this year so that you will end up with a year with great abundance. And that will be your portion in the name of Jesus. So, Elijah was a man who enjoyed so much of this. In 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 3, the Bible says, Elijah said to Ahab, there shall not be dew nor rain this year, but according to my word. And in 1 Kings 17, 24, now by this I know that you are a man of God, because the word of God in your mouth is true. That was the testimony of a woman. I pray for you today that this year the word of God will be true in your mouth. In 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 1, he had an instruction to Elijah. And it came to pass after many days that the word of the Lord came to Elijah in the third year, saying, go and show yourself unto Ahab, and I will send rain upon the earth. That's why we prayed about leading. Every step Elijah took, he was led. He didn't just act anyhow. God spoke to him, he acted on God's word. This year, you will not move anyhow. You will listen to instruction from heaven. In the name of Jesus. And in verse 41 of 1 Kings chapter 18, and Elijah said unto Ahab, get thee up, eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundance of rain. As at that time, was there any rain? There was no rain. There was no rain. But this man believed that whatever he says, he's going to see. And God said, and God saw. And God said, and God saw. And God said, and God saw. I pray for you this year. Whatever you say, you will see. Ah, be careful, though, because some people will go and say something now. What it means is that you have to be careful what you say. There's a sound of abundance of rain. Elijah started by obeying God. God said, go and show yourself to the king, and I will send rain on the earth. There are two categories of people that can create their great abundance. And I'll describe them to you this morning, and then I'll close. The first category of people that can create their own great abundance are the promise claimers. What did I call them? Promise claimers. They claim God's promise. They hold on to God's promise. That's why I said standing on the word of God. They hold on tenaciously unto God's promise. They are the promise claimers. The second category of people that are going to create their own great abundance are the prayer conquerors. They are not prayer warriors. They are prayer conquerors. Those are the two categories of people. Elijah belonged to these two categories. He started by claiming the promise. These promises are valid. We have so many precious promises of God. In the Bible, there are over 7,000 promises that are sure, that cannot fail. Elijah claimed that promise. He said, go and show yourself to the king. Very simple instruction. Listen, if it's some people, they will rationalize first. Say, why should I go to the king first? Let God bring rain first. Then I'll go and announce to the king that, yes, I was aware. God told me before. Say, this one is very risky. Anything God tells you will never appeal to the human intellect. Most of the time, it doesn't say things because it says, my thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are my ways your ways. He says, as the heaven is higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. Most of the time, when he gives people instruction, it doesn't tally with their common sense. Does it tally with their common sense? I'm used to that already. A man said there is no wine. And they went to him. And he said, go and fill the water pot. And they filled water pot. And after they came back, they said, we are finished. They were expecting him to go and order for chemical to pour inside. And he said, go and begin to serve it. He said, what? Serve water? Would that not be more embarrassment? So we can easily announce that there is no more wine instead of serving water. But as the man obeyed and he carried the water to begin to serve, the water became wine. There are so many people who are waiting at the edge of their miracle because they refuse to take the first step. Until the priest took the step into Jordan, Jordan did not part. Until they took the first step into the Red Sea did not part. God is waiting for you. If you're a promise claimer, you should be able to know that the God we serve is a God. According to Romans 4:21, you should be persuaded that what he has promised, he can perform. You should be persuaded that according to Ephesians 3:20, that now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you ask or think. If you're a promise claimer, you should know. The person who is promising you, you should know that according to Numbers 23:19, God is not a man that he should lie. He's not the son of man that he should repent. Whatever he cannot do, he doesn't talk about it. If you're a promise claimer, you should know that we have pr- precious premises in the Bible. Don't look at your limitation of circumstance, but what has he told you? Paul the apostle in Acts 27 verse 25, he said, even though there is chaos now, he said, but be of good cheer, for it shall be as it was told me. The word of God is above every circumstance. The word of God is above every situation. The word of God is superior to your expert knowledge. The word of God is superior to your professional knowledge. That's why when he told Peter, lay down the net, Peter did not argue. He said, sir, we have toiled all night in fishing. The best time to catch fish is in the night. We are professionals. But nevertheless, at your word, I will lay down the net. And what was the result? The reason many believers are not going to enter their great abundance this year is simple disobedience. Because of lack of faith and because of fear. Elijah, go and show yourself to the king, and I will send rain upon there. Why not do your own side first and wait whether God will do his own? If Elijah had not done his own part, God will not send rain. Promise claimers. You should also be good promise claimers if you know, if you have an understanding of the prior work of God. He has done it before. He can do it again. He had done it before. Elijah knew that it was this God who was faithful to him at the brook. He told him, I'm going to send ravens. And ravens came and was feeding Elijah. Ravens of all birds, the most greedy bird, was able to eat and remain for Elijah to bring. Because I'm sure it's not everything God gave raven that raven delivered. I trust raven. you know, he's more out of it. But because he was under compulsion, he has to deliver to Elijah twice a day. Elijah had known that this same God was the one who helped him when he was confronting the widow. And he said, the barrel of oil will not dry. And it didn't dry. What has God done for you before? I like keeping testimonies. That's why in Revelation 12, 11, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. What did David use to conquer Goliath? Testimony. Testimony. 1 Samuel 17, 24. Nevertheless, the Lord, who delivered me from the paw of the lion and the bear, he will deliver Goliath into my hand. I know lawyers will talk about precedent. Precedent is much more applicable in the Bible. Has he done it before? Has he done it before? And I always tell people, when people come to you and they say, Pastor, this is my problem. You don't know how terrible it is. Nobody has ever gone through it. I say, God forbid. God forbid, though. Because if you go through a problem that nobody has ever gone through, you are on danger list. Oh. It doesn't exist anywhere. Whatever happens, that's what the Bible says, has existed before. And all you need to find out is, how was it solved? Prayer work of God will help you to be a good promise claimer. In Malachi 3:6, the Bible says, for I am the Lord, I change not. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed. God has done it before and is going to do it again. In 2019, year of election, you know it was year of election, both in Nigeria and in Foursquare. And God told us it's our year of covenant of peace. Was there peace or not? He's done it before. He's done it before. Then last year, he told us it's our year of divine all-round sufficiency. Was it sufficient or not? He's done it before. He's done it before. What he did for us last year was like raining manna from heaven. You know when it rained manna for them from heaven? They said those who carry plenty, they didn't suffer. Those who didn't have enough, they didn't suffer. At the end of the day, it's the equation balance. That's what he did last year. There was no insufficiency. Everything balanced. Because he had promised. And this year is telling you, it's your year of great abundance. Will you believe it or not? He's done it before. He can do it again. It's not anything to him. The second category of people who can create their own great abundance, like Elijah, are the prayer conquerors. One of the major problems that we have in Christianity is that there are too many people making mouth, and they don't back it up with anything. Made mouth, not based on God's word. Made mouth, not based on prayer. Just made mouth. Claim it and have it. There's nothing like that. Thank God for the message during the youth blast. Somebody say, I claim it, I claim it, I claim it. He wakes up in the morning, he doesn't go anywhere. I claim it, I claim the best job, I claim the best job. There was a young man who was doing that. He has big proposals. When they ask him, what do you want to do? He say he wants to start dry cleaning work. And when he gave the list, there is 300 kVA generator on his list. There is an industrial dry cleaning machine on his list. He said, I'm trusting God. God is going to bring somebody to finance all this. You that you don't even know how to wash pants, you want to buy industrial cleaning machine and you want to buy 300 kVA generator to back it up. Too much talk, no action. And I've said it again and again. When you have vision without action, it will turn to television. It's television. And you know the worst thing about television? When you are watching television in the night and you sleep off, the television will be watching you. Every vision must be backed up with action. So when he gave us year of great abundance, and you begin to sing great abundance, and they say 40 days prayer and fasting, you say for what? What do I need it for? And then you don't need great abundance. Jesus, the disciples came to him. They saw the way he was casting out demons, and people were healing him. Then somebody brought small demon to them. And then they were stuck. They said, but the master used to cast them out very easily. Then they brought them to Jesus, and Jesus drove the demon out. Then they went to him shamefully. They said, oh God, be like, say, we just begin to learn. How did you do it? He said, this type. There's always this type around. This kind does not go out but by prayer and fasting. Do you know that in every year there's a this kind? That's why we start the year with prayer and fasting, so that all the this kind in that year, we take care of them. This kind, you say, even if you can overrun every other demon, but this type does not go out except by prayer and by fasting. And somebody was asking, so been at 30 days, would they do before? Why 40 days? And a man said, who is not even a believer, he said, if you are doing the same thing, the same way, and you expect a different result, it's a sure sign of insanity. It means your head is not correct. So if you are expecting great abundance, and you've been doing 30 days, and I told you the last time we ever did 40 days was 25 years ago. You know the time to do 40 days? It don't pass. Prayer conquerors. Those are the people. In James 5, 17 to 18. Elijah was a man of life passion. As we are. And he prayed earnestly that it will not rain. And it rained not. And he prayed again. And the heaven gave rain. The earth brought forth a fruit. Desperate prayers get desperate answers. Plant, you know, we were going to plant a church some time ago. And while we were in the field, the Sunday morning, there was this strong thunderstorm. Very strong. And where we were, because we did a shed for the church. In those days, we used to buy land. And then we do shed for the church. And then we plant the church. We did a shed for the church. And we're under the shed. And this strong thunderstorm came. There was no wall. I began to carry people's roof. It will carry somebody else's roof. Lank it on another man's roof. Blah. All of us had to gather at the center around the altar. And we began to pray. Say, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Because you can imagine, we used rods to hold the roof. No ceiling. So wind will come and it will carry it. carry it like this. Carry anywhere that thing is carried and lands. If it's a building, the building is gone. If there are a human being inside, they are finished. We cried to God. I can never forget that prayer. You see, when you pray desperate prayer, I know they forget. We cried. All of a sudden, I just heard, bam! What happened? The wind tore the aluminum from beginning to the end. And then the wind was able to have its way so that the roof now rested. We clapped. Even though our roof was damaged, we clapped. You say, God, well done, sir. You did this one well. Because if it had carried that roof, in fact, they will ask who sent you with the level of damage. So desperate situations require desperate prayers. You have 365 days to go ahead of you. You cannot give away 40 days to secure the remaining 325 days. What percentage is that? So small. Prayer conquers. Elijah was an humble person. Very humble. That's the first thing. Because the quality of the prayer that will deliver answer, that will give you great abundance this year. Let me just run over it. Number one, it will be a prayer rendered in humility. That's why we're fasting. In 2 Chronicles 7:14, it says, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and I will heal their land. There are people under the sound of my voice this morning. The Lord told me when I was preparing for this message, God sends me to you and he asked me to inform you that your arrogance will carry you nowhere this year. So you better bury your pride and come penitently so that he can forgive your sins and he can heal your life. The reason why we are fasting for 40 days is to humble ourselves. Because when you fast, flesh is humbled and the spirit is elevated. Number two, it must be a prayer that is specific. When Elijah went to pray, apart from the humility of the father, he bowed down his head and put his head between his knees. That was a sign of humility. He was bowing down before God so that he can stand before Ahab. Until you bow before God, you cannot stand before man. That's why I say God receives the proud but gives grace to the humble. That's why he could face a king like Ahab, because he had already humbled himself before his maker. You can't be proud before God and expect to be proud before men. You'll be finished. Number two, his prayer was specific. He sent his servant to check. He knew what he was looking for. In verse 43, he sent his servant to check the crowd because he knew what he was looking for. This prayer of God, bless me, is too general. That's why I told you for over 10 years now, I've engaged in the habit of developing a shopping list. And God has always been faithful. If you don't know where you are going, how will you know when you arrive? Is somebody following me now? You go to the car park and they say, where are you going? You say, any motor. And you enter the motor. And when they get to where they are going, they say, oh, God, we don't reach. You say, hey, so fast. Because he didn't know where he was going to start with. This is the beginning of the year. Where do you want to be by December? You should know it by now. You should know it. Are you looking for admission? What do you want exactly? What do you want exactly? Do you know that in Psalm 20 verse 4, one of my favorites said, grant you according to your own heart and fulfill all your counsel. God is prepared to grant you according to your own heart. But when God comes and it reaches your heart and there's nothing there, like somebody said, but when you bless nothing, nothing times 1 million is what? It's nothing. There must be something for God to work with. Elijah knew what he wanted. He was specific. Any prayer that would be a prayer of breakthrough, that would deliver great abundance must be specific. And as you are specific in your prayer, God will answer you. I say, God will answer you. Somebody was saying, Shebi, it has been promised already. You know what we call it? We call prayers that you make after you have received the promise enforcement. You know, there are so many laws in Nigeria that are not enforced. It's the day somebody break the law and they don't like the face of the person, they go and dig it up. When they dig it up and they take him to court, and the man say, ah, this kind of law exists, it's because you don't know. So many of them like that. But in the Bible, there are so many promises. It is our own responsibility to enforce it. Make sure it performs for us. This year, it will work for you. Number three, his prayer was not just rendered in humility. His prayer was not just specific. His prayer was also persistent. He sent his servant how many times? 7 times. The man will come. We say, oh God, nothing, no. Second time, nothing, no. Third time, nothing, nothing. Fourth time, nothing. Fifth time, nothing. If not you, what will have happened? He say, oh boy, I beg. Be like, say, no fuel inside this motor. Make I no follow him. But those who will get the biggest from God, they are the patient people. Elijah told Elisha, you have asked for a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I'm taken away, you will get it. No matter how hard what you ask for is this year, in this year of great abundance, God will deliver it to you. He said, you have asked for a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I'm taken away, you will get it. And you know, seeing when he's taken away means moving from Bethel to Giga, from Giga to Jordan, from Jordan to Jericho. That's a long distance. And the man kept following. He kept following. He kept following. He followed him to the last bus stop. If you follow God this year, you won't miss the way. If you follow God this year, he will deliver for you. His prayer was rendered in humility. His prayer was specific. His prayer was persistent. Finally, his prayer was rendered with expectation. As you draw up your shopping list, if your own contains that you are going to wed, I want you to begin to imagine yourself in your wedding gown. And imagine yourself dancing to the front. He was praying with expectation. That's why I'm sure the servant at the point must have been tired. He said, my friend, go and check again. Because I know God is coming. I told you the story of the boy who said, my father is coming. The classroom went under because of earthquake. All his classmates began to cry. This young boy did not cry. A primary school pupil. He would look around and say, why are you crying? They say, we're already buried in the ground. He said, me? My father is coming. My father is coming. He was so full of expectation. I'm telling somebody who can believe God this year, God is coming for you this year. This year is going to be your year. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I said this year will be your year. 1 year like that, my wife, we had 2 grown-up daughters living with us then. And she went for June rally and saw one woman who said, my 2 grown-up daughters were there this year. And the woman was rolling. And my wife said, huh? So it's possible like this. Okay, me too. I kill behind you. So the following year, she began to say it all over the way. This year is my year. This year is my year. I said, this is your song. This year is my year. When the thing come, you go see I'm all. By May, one of our daughters came. He said, well, I'm ready to marry now. 2 weeks later, the second one came and said, I'm ready to marry now. I began to beg. I said, una, make una forgive, make una have pity for me. Have pity for me now. He said, so I turned to my wife and said, this year is my year. This year is my year. The thing don't come now. But whether the devil likes it or not, this year is your year. I said, this year is your year of great abundance. You can shape your own year of great abundance. With the word of your mouth, you can shape it. With your prayers, you can shape it. The prayer is just halfway now. So you still have 20 days that you can use to shape it. Not just did he pray with expectation. You know, without expectation, there is no manifestation. Not only did he pray with expectation, At the end of the day, his prayer brought results. Your prayer will bring results this year. In verse 44, verse 45, he was answered. The Bible said, the heaven became black with clouds and wind. And there was what? A great rain. There was a great rain. Where you have experienced dryness in 2020, there shall be great rain this year. I say there shall be great rain this year. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. As I round up, one thing I want to leave you with. It will be a waste of time and energy for you to pray and not get answers. And it's a possibility. It's possible to fast for 40 days and not get answer. It's possible to draw up shopping list and not get answer. You ask me how and why. The first problem will be unbelief and fear. If you are afraid, that's what God will tell them. Anyone that is afraid, let him go back now. Let him go back now. If you are afraid, you may not get answers. Number two, and that one is the most serious one, is sin. That's why Jesus came. He came so that we can have access to God. In Isaiah 59 verse 1, he said, God's ear is not deaf that he cannot hear. Neither is his hand short that he cannot deliver. He said, but your sin has created a barrier between you and God. So he can't hear you. He cannot hear you. And that is what I want you to take care of this morning. Because there's a word of assurance. In Hebrews chapter 8 verse 2, it says, for I will be merciful to their unrighteousness. And their sins and their iniquities I will remember no more. I want you to bow down your heads as you pray. Just bow down your heads there. Bow down your heads and talk to the Lord. Talk to the Lord. I want to, before I pray for you, for the grace to believe God, to claim all the promises, and the grace to pray through all your shopping list. I want to give opportunity to those who know that for some time you have not been in good relationship with God. And God wants to answer your prayer this year. And you want to say, Lord, I want to be your son. I want to mend my relationship with you. The Bible says, for whosoever shall call, Romans 10:13, upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. If you are there and you are saying, Lord, because of the prayers we are going to pray later, you need to take this one away first. If you are saying, Lord, I want to do like the prodigal son who cut off from his father, but he came, when he came, the father embraced him. You can put your hand on your chest where you are and pray very simple prayer. Say, Father, I am here again. I have come back again. You say, whosoever comes to you, you will in no wise cast away. You say, our sins and our iniquities, you will remember no more. Put your right hand on your chest. I want to pray for you. I want to pray for you. Maybe you have been a believer and you just slide back a bit. You want restoration so that this year's prayer and fasting can deliver for you. So that your shopping list, so that you will not pray in vain. You will not fast in vain. If you belong to any of these two categories, I'd like you to put your right hand on your chest. I'm going to pray now. I'm going to pray now. And as I want to pray, I want you to raise your left hand up. Just raise your left hand up so that I can pray for you. I want to pray for you. Just raise your left hand up. God wants to answer your prayer this year. He doesn't want you to just pray and shout and scream and fast in vain. Just raise your left hand up. I'm going to pray now. God bless you. God bless you. Father, we thank you for these hands. We give you praise because you are a God of mercies. I ask, Lord, today that for these ones, show them mercy in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been the barrier between them and you, Lord, the Bible said the blood of Jesus Christ, your son, cleanses us from all sin. I ask that today that your blood will atone for them. In the name of the Lord Jesus, as they confess you as Lord, come into their hearts. In the name of Jesus, give them a new life. In the name of Jesus, let the old life of frustration pass away. as they open their mouth to pray, answer their prayer in the name of Jesus. Let their names be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Thank you because you have heard our prayers. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. I want you to rise up on your feet, everybody. We're going to pray. I want you to rise up on your feet, everybody. How many of you have had a shopping list of what you want God to do for you this year? Oh, God bless you. I can see those hands. I can see those. I'm going to pray now on those shopping lists. Psalm 20 verse 4. Grant you according to your own heart and fulfill all your counsel. It was Elijah who said, there shall be no dew nor rain. Eh? But according to my word. God, no send them home. Did you read it very well in the Bible? It was because God is a God of mercy. After he sealed up heaven, he didn't even care about opening it. He didn't care about opening it. It was himself. He said, unless by my word, it was his making. It was his making. The only thing he was sure was that it was in line with God's word. That's all. If what is on your shopping list is in line with God's word, I want to assure you this morning, go and write it down. You are getting it. You are getting it. I'm used to it. At the end of the year, people will come screaming. Say, I had 8 things and they start ticking. They start ticking. There was 1 year God gave us a theme during the first quarter. He said, it's our year of early satisfaction. Mommy, you remember? Within the first quarter of the year, everybody's shopping list was ticked. I told them in the church, I said, draw up a new one. Draw up a new one. Because it's a year of double portion. Listen to me. God is real. But most of the time, we are the one that curtail him. That's why I say you can create your own great abundance. I want to pray for you. Just raise your hand up. If you have a list. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you because of the authority of your word. Say, whatsoever thing you desire, when you pray, you say, believe that you have it and you will receive it. That is your word. Say, grant you according to your own heart and fulfill all your counsel. I pray for this, your people, including those who are watching me online or on television. Whatever is their desire and their goal for this year that is in line with your word, Father, hear them from heaven and grant it in the name of Jesus. In this year of great abundance can accommodate everything and everything. I therefore ask today that for these shopping lists that have been drawn up by your people, either written down on paper or written on the tablets of their heart, I ask, Lord, that because you are a God that answers prayers and you promise to grant us according to our own heart, Father, grant it this year in the name of Jesus. Bible said, then the ransomed of the Lord shall come back with rejoicing. Say, an everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. I pray that this year shall be your year. I say this year will be your year of testimonies. I say this year will be your year of advancement. I say this year will be your year of progress. I say this year will be your year of productivity. Whatever we stand on your way of going forward, that thing will go backwards. Whatever we stand on your way of going upwards, let that thing be sunk in the ground. In the name of Jesus, every flood on your way intended to swallow you, I decree today, let the ground open its mouth and swallow them in the name of Jesus. thank you, Father, because you've done it. Your people will come back rejoicing with their testimonies. For in Jesus' name, we have prayed.